This is our Skin for Life Ultra Scrubber and Ultrasonic Wave System machine. On the left-hand side of your machine, you'll see that you have the Ultra Scrubber. The Ultra Scrubber is our blade for lifting and proliferation of dead skin cells. You'll see that the timer is set as a default of 20. In your manual, you will notice that I have your treatment settings as far as the time for 8 minutes to up to 10 minutes for application, for a complete application with the Ultra Scrubber. However, you can default to 20 minutes if you're working on multiple areas, whether it's the face, the neck, the chest, arms, or back area. You can increase your time to 60 minutes if you're working on more multiple areas. You will notice that in the individual intensity of 1 to 3, 1 meaning low frequency when working with sensitive skin and trouble skins, and then 2 meaning medium frequency when working with resistive oily skins, sun damaged skin, blemished skins, skins that may be a little bit more thicker, a little bit more trouble, a little bit more accumulation of dead skin cells around the follicle area. 3 is high frequency, sun damaged skin, oily and troubled skins again. But again, depending on the amount of accumulation of dead skin cells within that, within the areas of the face. Sun damage mean it can mean directly from the sun or from tanning booths, something that has thickened the epidermal cells that you need to create more circulation to cause proliferation of those dead skin cells using the Ultra Scrubber blade. When you're looking at your mode, this is your machine intensity. It goes from constant. Constant is, again, with resistive skins like closed comedones, miliocysts, open comedones, oily, troubled skin, more blemished skins. You can work with the hands, the elbows, the shoulders, the back of the body. So this is going to give you a constant flow of that cavitation. 75% is more resistive skins. Again, it can be more of a thickening, accumulation, over-accumulation of dead skin cells around the follicle wall where you need extra vibration, extra cavitation around those areas so that you can cause more proliferation. 50% is going to be more sensitive skins, troubled and blemished skins, back, shoulders, and feet. So with this being said, constant, 75% or 50%, you have to look at the accumulation of dead skin cells and how that you need to cause that excessive amount of vibration or cavitation that the blade gives the skin, and how much you want to lift and remove the dead skin cells, but on a safe and effective manner or treatment for that particular skin. Because if you're working with sensitive skins, it could be anywhere from constant to 50%. But if it has more of a thicker kind of consistency of overaccumulation of dead skin cells, you might have to work with the 75% in order to really cause the amount of vibration needed for proliferation of those dead skin cells. So when you're looking at your blade, in order to power up your blade, you have your power switch on the blade itself. You just have to press it once and you will hear the clicking sound of the blade. Now this is also important when you are working with your Ultra Scrubber blade. You want to make sure that it is working and that you have complete cavitation. What you can do is you can take your a toner, for example, something that has water, or maybe dab a little bit of water on the blade. And as you run the blade and you can spray it, you can actually see where the cavitation is beginning as far as the jumping of the molecules of the toner or the water that you're using. You can make sure that the blade is performing the way it should, and it is right now performing just the way it should. So if you wanted to press the intensity and you wanted to increase that, then you can also see the amount of adjustments that you've done by spraying the water on the blade to see how much vibration you're causing. We're going to turn this off. With the Ultra Scrubber Blade, when we begin with performing the treatment, you will see the directional application that I perform on the skin, and then we'll go through the settings together. On the right side of the machine, you'll see that you will start working with the ultrasonic wave portion of the machine. You'll see that the intensity, the machine intensity, you'll have an up arrow and you'll have a down arrow. You will also see that you can select a 1 megahertz or a 2 megahertz handpiece. The 1 megahertz is your flat head handpiece, and your 2 megahertz is the cone shape of the handpiece. Why are they different? The 1 megahertz, which is the flat headpiece, this is for more of the actual entire face, the flat areas of the face. The cone shape handpiece is going to be more around the eye area, around the lip area, more on the contour area, where you're having to isolate a little bit more volume or fullness to the face when you're working around the eyes and the lips and so forth. The 1 megahertz you will select, and you will see that again you have a timer that defaults to 20 minutes. When you perform with this particular application, again your maximum time is about 10 minutes for the face, and you will see that you have constant and pulse. Constant is a duration performance application between, let's say, 10 minutes. You can maybe go up to the maximum of 15 minutes on constant frequency. Pulse is more of an intermittent frequency for deeper waves. Duration, you might have a duration of performance application between 5 to 10 minutes of pulse. So my suggestion is that you start with constant, to really work on lifting movements of the face, to really fill or create fullness to the face with, again, everything that is underneath that particular handpiece is going to be all your elixirs, such as your serums and your moisturizers, to have more nutritional value for the skin, but to also really intensify the fullness or the volume of the skin as well. This is great for sun damage, wrinkles, fine lines, if you're working on scar tissue, that kind of thing, that you're trying to densify the skin. When you are actually putting in the cord, please be aware that this is a twist lock plug. So when you actually insert the plug, you want to make sure that you line it up with the little the dot or the little circle that is on the actual plug-in or the DIN plug. So when you want to lock, you're going to twist it, and therefore it locks in place. The red handpiece performs the exact same way. You twist and it's locked in place. So when you remove, you want to also unlock by turning it to the left and then removing it. To place in, insert, turn to the right, and it's locked. So when we're in our 1 megahertz and we're in the constant mode, and you can set your time, let's say we want to set it for the 10 minutes for the face, working with the flat handpiece, we want to hit start, and you'll see that the light next to the timer will start blinking, and that means it's in its working mode. Then you can increase the line of green. You can start green, means that it's going to be on a lower end of frequency. So if you're working with sensitive skins or skins that may be a little bit more hypersensitive, maybe a little bit more of a thinning skin, the more you increase, the more you're giving more of a sensation of warmth to the skin and creating more more sonic waves, more performance of the waves to create more activity for the skin. So the more you go up, the more it will increase the activity of the sonic waves. So again, it really depends on the type of skin you're working with. Whether it's a thin skin, a sensitive skin, somebody's that might be a little bit thicker, that you're having to really build up more of a penetrable value to the skin in order to get these sonic waves to start working in that area. When you're also working with sensitive skin, you want to bring it down into the green bars. Now you can also test your handpiece by the same test that you did that you performed with your blade, by squirting the handpiece and increasing it, and you can actually see how it jumps around on the handpiece. And it will create a heat as far as a steam to the skin. So when you're working with ultrasound and you're working with sonic waves, that type of penetration creates a heat value to the skin. So please remember that it does not have to be hot to the skin or warm to the skin. It's all about interacting these sonic waves so that it interacts with the nature of the epidermal layers in order to strengthen, to create volume and fullness for the skin. Stop. Okay, so once you've completed your flat handpiece on the entire area, as far as, again, with lifting and firming movements, and do not forget the intensity. When you're looking at your green bar, the higher you go, the more intense the sonic waves are to the handpiece, more high pitched they are, as far as to, you know, really cause more of a deeper penetration. And when you're working with your constant and you're manipulating the skin in massaging techniques for that 10 to 15 minutes, you can transition the mode to pulse, where you get more of an intermittent response, and you can also hear this with the handpiece. It will intermittent make a longer pulse or a sonic wave to the skin to really get more value of fullness, more volume to the skin, working on isolated areas like a scar tissue, a wrinkle, and that type of thing to cause more epidermal thickness. So when you're finished with the flat handpiece, then you can transition to the 2 megahertz. But as soon as you do this, you see that the intensity went off. That's normal. The machine is still working, but we transition to the cone handpiece for more isolated areas around the eyes, around the lips, and so forth. So we can build up. Working with the green, I'm in pulse, I'm going to make it constant, and then I'm going to work on around the eye area. Around the eye area, I do recommend that you keep it in the green spectrum, because you don't want to spend a whole lot of time. Remember, depending on the bone structure of the eye and how bony the eye is, as far as not enough adipose tissue to support the eye, you want to work on the eye at the minimum of, I would say, from 5 to 10 minutes, and then work around certain areas that you want to increase with volume, like around the lip area and so forth. So the eye area is maximum, you know, maybe 10 minutes, depending on the area that you're working, as far as the upper, the supraorbital area versus the infraorbital area. But it can be as minimum as 5 minutes for both eyes, not each eye, the whole treatment for that particular, those particular eye areas are going to be from 5 to 10 minutes in total, okay? As well as transitioning to the pulse, especially if you're working around a lip or the eye area that has extreme lined or wrinkled look around the eye, you want to finish it off with another 5 minutes of a pulse sensation to really build some thickness to those epidermal layers. So once you've completed this step, you can hit the start button to turn it off, and then go ahead and once you've completed your procedure, you can sanitize the hand pieces by wiping them off with either some sandy wipes, something that is germicidal, or use a high percentage of alcohol in order to wipe and disinfect the hand pieces. So this is the Ultra Scrubber and the Ultrasonic Wave Machine. Again, you have the Ultra Scrubber to the left-hand side where you have your own port, where you have your time, your individual intensity, and your machine intensity as far as the percentage of how the vibration is related to the skin and the cavitation. On the right-hand side, you have your ultrasonic wave system, and you have the intensity using the 1 megahertz, which is your flat hand piece, the 2 megahertz, which is your cone-shaped hand piece, and you have your constant, which is constant vibration of the sonic waves. There's no intermittent response. It is a continuous response to the skin. And then you have your pulse as your intermittent response, which causes more localized intensity when you're working with wrinkles, scar tissue, and so forth, in order to build up more of a sensation, more activity of volume and densifying the skin. You have your timer. You have default of 20 minutes, and you can increase it or decrease it depending on whom you're working with, as well as your start and stop button or start and pause button that you can activate the system and then increase your individual intensity. The higher you go, the more intense the frequency is. And remember, heat is not the objective. Heat can actually break down tissue to a certain point because, again, we are more acclimated to heat than we are to cold. The whole idea is to intensify the vibration for the skin so that it can communicate with the epidermal layers of the skin and create more volume, more fullness to the skin, and really isolate certain wrinkles or scar tissue, working with pigmentation variations that you really need to focus and create more activity within that skin for penetrable purposes of working in the product, getting more lifting and firming movements to the skin. So with this being your exfoliation and this being your nutrition to the skin, and to work with interacting with the layers, the epidermal layers of the skin, to create volume and fullness, and to work on the nutritional support of what your products may provide for the gap junctions of the skin. So this is our Skin for Life Ultra Scrubber Ultrasonic Wave Machine. And if you have any questions, you may always call Skin for Life and visit our website, www.skinforlife.com, or call us on our toll-free number, which is 866-312-7546. Thank you very much.